The Philippines and Vietnam are seeking to enhance their strategic partnership. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Vietnamese Prime Minister Pham Minh Chinh held a bilateral meeting Tuesday on the sidelines of the ASEAN summit in Laos. Marcos said their partnership is progressing with more opportunities in the offing. The two countries are both claiming parts of the South China Sea, but have managed to settle the disputes peacefully and even cooperate on several fronts such as search and rescue operations at sea. Both have also been vocal in rebuking China for illegally claiming nearly the entire strategic waterway, where trillions worth of seaborne goods pass through annually. Now, in January this year, Marcos traveled to Vietnam for a state visit and witnessed the signing of several economic and security deals. Among the agreements signed include deals on rice trade cooperation and incident prevention in the South China Sea. The Banco Central ng Pilipinas and the Bank of Thailand recently held a high-level bilateral meeting to exchange views and strengthen cooperation in various areas of central banking. Now, on the agenda, discussing the role of central banks in capital market development, payment systems development, and measures for fraud prevention and consumer protection, as well as artificial intelligence use cases. The central banks also talked about other potential collaborations, such as study visits and webinars, to further broaden and enhance their long-standing cooperation and bilateral ties. The Trade Department urges Filipino entrepreneurs to take advantage of preferential rates for exports to South Korea. They're saying that about 97% of Philippine exports to South Korea have this, meaning Filipino exporters either pay lower or no tariffs on their exports to Seoul. The agency adds the newly ratified free trade agreement between the Philippines and South Korea is expected to benefit the local banana industry as well as the pineapple industry. Now remember, the Senate ratified this free trade agreement back in September to increase exports of those agricultural products. So this is expected to complement the existing FTA between ASEAN as a whole and South Korea, as well as the Regional Comprehensive Partnership Agreement, or RCEP.
For several years, tayo po ang may pinakamalaking market share ng fresh banana sa South Korea. In fact, noong 2013, no, umaabot sa 98% yung ating market share sa South Korea. And through the years, medyo bumaba na po yan. No? In fact, ang recent data na nakuha namin noong 2023, bumaba na siya sa 65%. Marami na pong kompetensya na nanggagaling sa ibang bansa, katulad po ng Vietnam, Ecuador, among others. Ang Vietnam, lumalaki rin unti-unti ang kanilang market share. Pero ang Vietnam ho kasi, ang saging nila doon, pag in-export nila sa South Korea, zero na. Samantalang yung ating saging, kapag in-export natin sa South Korea, meron pang 30% na tariff rate. So dito sa bilateral FTA na yun, ito yung negotiate namin, eventually maging zero. At nakuha naman po natin yan.
Other areas of cooperation include economic and technical cooperation, which will cover exploring partnerships on R&D of e-vehicles, mineral processing, and automotive industry. President Marcos met with his South Korean counterpart earlier this week in a bid to boost economic ties. Now, here's another Dennis Oy story. The different Dennis Oy from Davao this time. DITOTEL community hitting the 13 million mark in subscriber base with a 12% market share in the local telecom space. This is Davao-based businessman Dennis Oy's telco firm marked its fifth and final technical audit from regulators. As Jackie Pascual tells us, profitability is now in sight. Take a look.
The National Telecommunications Commission and the Department of Information and Communications Technology welcome the passing of DITO's fifth and final independent technical audit. The audit is part of the conditions given to the so-called third telco when it was given the Certificate of Public Convenience and Necessity in 2019. NTC Commissioner Ella Blanca Lopez says DITO now has a nationwide coverage of 86.3%, exceeding its promise of 84% coverage on its fifth year. Minimum average broadband speed was reported at 92.87 Mbps for 4G and 597 Mbps for 5G, surpassing the promise of 55 Mbps.
These results clearly reflect DITO's commitment to meeting and exceeding regulatory requirements while contributing meaningfully to the development of digital infrastructure in the Philippines.
Together, we hope to achieve our common goal of building a nation that is connected and digitally enabled.
Dito Telecommunity CEO Eric Alberto says their entry to the market has challenged the telco duopoly of Globe and Smart and has led to improving telco services overall.
Having true competition in the market is that it actually redounds to the benefit of consumer. Internet speeds have gone up from last 5 years. Prices have really come down to, you know, just a little over 50 cents, US cents per GB.
Despite passing the final audit, Dito officials assert there are still many challenges in the telco space.
The refusal of some of our competitors to open interconnection, despite clear mandates from regulators. We are confident that through dialogue and continued support of the government, that this challenge will be overcome.
Let us now shift our focus, our energies, our skills, and our resources to the greater challenge of co-building the nation's digital economy.
Alberto adds they have already spent about $1 billion per year, and he eyes to break even EBITDA by the end of 2025.
That over the next next year, actually, our ambitions to be EBITDA positive, all the way leading to our the next 3-4 year plan by 2028. It is ambition to get ourselves to be profitable.
Alberto also announces Dito has recently reached 13 million subscribers, or around 12% market share. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.